Hey guys, what is going on? This is Larknok One, and welcome back to part 23 of my Let's Play of Civilization Beyond Earth. We are playing as the African Union, and we are going for a purity victory. Last time, we were able to take Tiangong from the PAC and Kuyen, and we have finally sued for peace, a lasting peace. The PAC are more or less defeated to an outpost of Ganzerig and Gongren, and that is just about the limit of their empire, if you want to call the remains of what was once a glorious Asian cooperative. Alas, it's gone. We also have a death ball here on the border of the Cavithans in case they drop a mine flower on us and we have to rush in and take it out quickly. We have the exit escape coming in 3 turns, and that will be victory for us. So let's go ahead and snooze a bunch of these guys, get a bunch of units on this northern border in case we are declared war on by the Franco-Iberians, or if we have to go to war, or if any other variation of that kind occurs. Whereas, you know, the rest of these guys can just kind of sleep. Just defend yourself, whatever, air intercept. Go up there, I don't care. Just go. Heal. Just chill for now. I think these guys are fine where they are. Most of these guys are good too. I kind of want to just speed right to the end now. Make choices if I absolutely have to that will affect the victory, but otherwise, the game is more or less determined. On exit escape. 3 turns remain. The one thing we could do is build trade routes in Tiangong and send them over to Janali, but I guess it's pretty much done at this point, so there's no point. Alright, I sent these guys down in case there was a border concern over here. There really won't be. Whatever. They're pretty much everything's good where it is. I'm fine with that. Whatever. Everything's alright. Just chill. Just chill. Come on, Exodus Gate. We need you to be done. We need you to be done already. Janali gonna hit 20 population soon.
Torgovlia,
no, mister, no.
If it's a sin to play God, then why would he leave his tools lying around?
Right, there's bioengineering. Not too useful, but whatever. The other thing we could do is have a... we could probably move towards... Supremacy 3, or actually, what level is it? Supremacy 6. Try to get orbital coverage, and then drop, phasal transporters around the world wherever we need to take them. Take out targets. That's an option. I'm not gonna pursue it. I think we're fine with the death ball. But again, many options actually available to you. This guy's built a lot of cities. And to think this whole time, all of our cities have like 38 combat strength. But that should be the Exodus Gate finishing. There we go. Boom. Here we go, Earth Explorer. Can we teleport you out? Yes, we can. Where do we want you? Right there is a good spot. You are in a fine location. All of you are in great locations. Alright, so Exodus Gate done. We could... Oh, the Xenomalayan was nerfed. It just makes me sad to look at it like that. Oh well. We can swap out to... No, let's build some Lev Destroyers. I think those are cool. We'll build them for shits and giggles.
Le commerce fonctionne quand on peut.
Yeah, just like give me stuff and I'll go through your territory and I won't ever give you anything significant in return. Sounds good to me. Here we go. Settle some Earthlings. Drop ourselves another one. And... orbital deploy. Quest decision. Okay, master gestures. Doesn't matter. Nothing matters. Lol. One thing we could be doing right now is, like, pumping our population out of the roof. That could be fun. At this point, we're on a time cap, just for victory. So nothing particularly will affect that. I'm gonna get this guy down here. Quest decision. Covert op, yay. I was intrigued looking at my gun. Not too good. We'll assign a dude there. Why not? Janali, what to do now? We could build everything in Janali if we want. Eh. I like tanks. Tanks are cool. Let's build tanks. Settle you. What's the limit? I know there's a limit on these guys. I think it's 6. What I recall. But anyways, we're gonna need another phasal transporter up soon. Tama made communications. Cool, buddy. You know who's home. Tabitha finished the mine flower. This is why we're here. With our little death ball. It's on the other side. We could war now and try to rush in. I believe these guys ignore zone of control, so it should be fine. Alright, so let's go ahead and grab the 1 health from Gene Smelters. Again, not that it matters. Settle our Earthling. Spot another. Send him here. Teleport him out there. Alright, this guy, could send this guy over that way. I don't, just for fun, I guess. We need to war her now.
No lies now.
Alright. Oh shit, didn't mean to do that. Okay. Yeah, we can just kind of roll on in. Again, ignoring zone of control with these units is really brokenly good, and is something that should have been fixed a while ago, but was never fixed. Doesn't really make sense. Tank army away! Oh my goodness. 0 sense was made. Captain's got a pretty cumulatively large army, but I don't know, dude. This is a big death ball. I don't really know if there's much you can do to a death ball like this. Yeah, you can take one part out. Who cares? All we gotta do is wipe your flower out. Do what you gotta do. Death ball isn't going anywhere. Wow. Yeah, the Slav Feds are actually really close. Always very close. To the KP border. Go ahead and move this guy in. The other hits we need. It's 3, I think. Yeah, see, that's the power of just being able to avoid zone of control. It's kind of insane. This flower will be dead before you know it. So I think we've destroyed it, and what do we have to do? Move in? I forget how you kill this thing. Maybe you have to move into it and pillage it? I'm not sure. Oh wow, we could probably hit Bondura, honestly. I'm gonna take out some of these tanks they've got. Let's do this quest decision first. And blast away. Unless they finish the Mind Flower next turn, it looks like we're going to be able to shut it down. Alright, tank finished here. Let's just go ahead and swap over to Research Focus. Because it does not completely matter. Yeah, why don't you just, like, here we go. Can we build another... Diesel transporter. Probably wise to have two active at any time. And this tank is done. We'll just send him eastward as well. Why not? Cool. It's a tank. And I don't care about you. Your flower is dead. You have no chance to survive. Make your time.
Yeah, do what you gotta do.
The whole point was just to take out a flower. Not to really do serious damage. Look at those shrikes, though. Oh, I think those are shrikes, right? Serious damage from those guys.
The laws of nature are weaker than planning, resolve, purpose, and will.
So there is the upgrade on Devastator, for example. Let's go ahead and grab that. That it matters. Settle down there, and I think it is 6, so I think we should be able to move one more guy there. So Phase will transport him there, and then this new Phase Transporter will be up. And we'll probably find another place to put him. I think here's probably a good spot. We can do it there, right? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Yeah, that's another good spot. Okay. Tech available. Let's just keep going towards purity stuff so we can get into the latest game purity units. Why not, man? Alright, so how do we take this thing out? Do we walk in? Is that how it works? Yeah, there we go. Goodbye, Mindflower. Can we take Mondo out now? Maybe. Maybe. We can do a lot of damage, actually. No joke, like, a lot of damage. Probably take it out next turn. If they do some serious counterattack. Send him eastward. Oh, did I not? I think I already spawned my guy and sent him, right? Yes, I definitely did. So they're gonna take out a bunch of these dragoons, but not all of them. I might not be able to hold it, but I think we can probably take Mandara. Oh no, not with these planes, I don't think. With these planes, I don't see it happening. Unless two strikes is enough, which I don't think it will be. Oh well, we took out the Mind Flower, that was the whole point of that. Oh, it might be! Oh, bitch, it might be. I don't have any melee units ready to go, so this... Yeah, I think we captured Mandara. That's hilarious! We took Mandara! I don't give a fuck! Alright, launch this guy right there. Make this where we wanted it. Settle our last little dude here. I think that's a maxed earth settlement there. Spawn another guy. And drop him down right there. Wander is done. Well, let's do something with it. I wonder how long it'll take them to retake it. We'll probably have it very soon. Doesn't bother me. Those Poseidons, though, those are scary. I believe they get their bonus from not being any adjacent, and it's just like huge combat bonus. Alright, settle down there. Can we get our Earth settling teleporting. There we go. And then we actually want to despawn this guy. And use our resources to go ahead and build another one for Magan. Orbital laser is not the right unit. We want the phasal transponder. Can you switch to something else, please? There we go. Oh, the orbital laser is just petroleum. We actually need our titanium back, so we need to trade to Elodie. You like us still, right? I hope so.
I think not.
What's that? Why do we have no strategic resources? I think it's because we gave them out to everybody else. Jeez. Well, she won't do it, so I guess we'll have to deal with the one we have. It's not such a bad situation. No, we kind of really do need that, so let's see if we can find someone else to sell us.
I haven't got
you got so much. Holy crap. Why do you hate us?
Contact our lawyers.
Contact our lawyers? I'm talking to you.
Are you kidding?
Are you kidding? So mean.
No
deal.
Get
out of my face. Jeez. Jeez. What did we ever do to you?
What do you want?
Why does everyone hate me? I was nothing but nice to people.
Yeah,
you're still pissed. Reasonable reasons. Highly reasonable reasons.
Bonjour, mon ami.
You like us, but we don't have anything we could possibly trade.
Un verre de vin
to get titanium
commencer.
From you. How are we running negative? Oh, you know what we could do is retire some of these guys. I mean, you force our hand, though. Oh, shit, that's not what I wanted. Wrong button. I want to delete them. They've done their duty, and they can return to their non-genetically engineered lives. Yeah, they're costing us a pretty penny. Titanium that we could be using for domestic uses. Here we go. That's what I wanted to do. Okay, that doesn't matter. We can just heal these guys up, I guess. They're not going to send in a melee unit. Aha, look at me, sending a massive fat tank across the sea. I'm so cool. Well, tell me when you send in a melee unit. Because until then, Mondo is mine, bud. Okay, down to zero. You. Retire. Settle in. Spawn another. Basal transport. And you're good. What's good, man? Oh, Cavitha. You're mind flower. You tried to connect with the planet. You see, here's the problem with that. We're bringing some friends over. You know? A few buddies of ours. Closing in oh so fast. Is the transponder done? We can probably just research focus for now. Settle in. Spawn another. And, you know, it doesn't matter. No melee ships. Does not matter. Not until rising tide. And it might matter a little bit. Tiny little bit. Alright, this guy, we're gonna launch him in our next spot for a city. 1, 2, 3. Here's not a bad spot. Right here, in fact. I think we can probably do it on that Magrail. Yeah, let's go ahead and put one there. I think you only need 3 spots. And then, like, one more. It doesn't need to be full. Their offer is just giving me a bunch of cities. My offer, peace. Sure, I don't really care. Give me free cities. I'll annex them. Why not? Thanks for your capital.
Torgovlia opiera się na potrzeby.
My city. Haha. Reggie's dowed me. Whatever, dude. Oh no, Reggie. Whatever will I do? Oh no. Oh my goodness. Like I care. I maybe need to move these things back. That's it.
Strong machines rally.
Can I build that? That's cool. I want geothermal. Whatever. I might want to move these things back, just the raiders, back to Magan in case they send literally anything towards Magan. Magan is, in fact, can't forget, a 38 production city. Sorry, 38 combat strength city. So it is by no means actually strong. How many of these Earth Settlers do we need again? I thought it's, shouldn't it tell me here? Yeah, 20. Okay, I don't really care. Just whatever. Just everything go disease. Nothing matters. Nothing matters. Army and purity reward. Okay. Good to know. This guy settling in. Spawn this one. Send him over. Transport. And these. I wanted these in Magan. Finally, I believe this phasal transporter has done its job and it is no longer needed. What we can do now is build another one. Should be the last one. New. You no longer need your open borders, bud. That is so funny. That death ball just kind of rolled in and took Mandara. I kind of forgive it. You're just... I can't. I'm so offended. It burns. Deep within my soul. Peace expired. Whatever. Settle me more. And here, drop another. Oh wow, we actually don't have the phasal transponder up yet. That's... whatever. I think we should be able to settle it next turn by just having moving this guy there. If he had been in the phasal transponder, he wouldn't actually have been able to settle, so... it's the same rate. It's just... not quite on point. Nothing matters. You can close in and take Agni, I don't care. A city that means nothing to me. How did I get this vision? Really, how did I get that vision? Oh my goodness, it's so weird. Transporter up. Oh, the transporter has been up. I've just been silly. Whatever. I guess I just forgot it was there. Where can I put another guy? I could probably drop around here. Nothing wrong with... hey, Lollibell is in the way, right? There's gotta be some place where I can drop. How's between Kuyin and Tabo? Is there any spot there? No, there's not. There's gotta be... there's definitely something up here? Tiangong, 1, 2, 3, boom, right there. That is a spot. That is a viable spot right there. Okay. In that case... take him, send him this way, and settle. Then take you, spawn another guy, right there, teleport yonder. And just chill, research. Donna, nana, nana. We're approaching the end of the game rapidly. I might just make this the last episode. It'll be an extra special long episode. But I'm gonna make this the last episode, because we are getting there. 7 more settlers remain. Borders settle down. Phasal transport right there. How many remain? Too many, I hope. This is how the end of the game tends to go. It's pretty kind of boring. You're just kind of trying to pump out those last guys. So I wouldn't blame you guys if you wanted to skip right to the end and see if you can, you know, just get to the ending. Oh wow, she looked cool there. She looked really cool.
I haven't got all day.
Cyan plants. Pretty cool. Alright, let's settle. Oh boy, that is... it's quite a force you have there. I'll have to shoot it. Well, we sunk that guy. Let's try to sink this one now. Wow. These are one-shotting them. Why is that? Is this a glitch? Like, oh god, they do a lot more damage than it says they do. Well, whatever. Next turn. Let's see what they want to do. Brazilians gab anything? I can bring it out now. Honestly, they could do some solid damage to my gun. It's only got 39 combat strength. I'm probably going to take Agni, I don't really care. Not bad, it's pushed up real close to my gun.
Computational and human resources should never have been separate strategic assets. Those who forget the past and its sacrifices become the forgotten dust.
That is a good quote, I like that one. Pop me out another. Diesel transport. True Aegis, whatever that is good for. Let's 60% win inside city. Sure. Dreadnought. Alright, we'll give you range. Why not? And the Predator! You can automatically have them heal every turn. That's sweet. True LV tank. That's just cool. And then with our Predators here, I suppose we could just obliterate all these ships. She's doing a lot more damage than they say they will. I wonder if it applies to the carriers, too. No, it does not. Have I spawned my guy yet? I have already. Research. Okay. Anything else to grab? I think we've hit our max upgrades on pretty much everything. So one thing we could do is just grab geophysics and see where the geothermal is. Not that it matters, but it's interesting.
Dust of a dying world must listen to the stones of a living world.
How much geothermal would we have gotten this whole time? Oh my goodness, a Yan would have been geothermal rich. Well, two at least. One in not available to us in the beginning of the game, and then one not really available to us. Kind of Tabo, I guess. Not so bad. It's nice that these guys heal every turn. These are great planes. Then quest decision. Why not? Doesn't matter. I wanted to get... let's just start getting some supremacy stuff. Supremacy points here or there. Settle down here. We can now probably send this guy up this way. And we'll just need three there. Put another one down here. Finish off at six. It doesn't really matter how you spread it out. Again, does not matter. We're bringing back people from Earth. As we always should have. Except that our own Exodus Gate kind of looks like it.
Stop talking about the weather and do something about it.
That's
for
right.
Once.
As I unlock some of this stuff, I get some of the starship stuff. So it's probably worth doing a little something. Screw it. Doesn't really matter. Just go ahead and grab this. Let me get even more harmony and supremacy points. Alright, you settle down right there. Spawn me another. I think we're good. Two or three turns out from the ending now. Oh boy. Goodbye, plane. Or ship. Sorry, I meant ship. Alright, here we go. Nope. Okay, I have to finish the mine flower, but we're probably gonna finish first. Good for you, Kavitha. Good for you. Although I do believe you can build up points for the mine flower as you go. So that's something we could worry about, but again, I think we're two turns out, we're gonna be fine. We're gonna be just dandy. Let me just grab. Yeah, this is a quick way to get good supremacy points. Doesn't matter to me. And last one. Alright, I think it's the last one, right? Well, we'll just send him here, transport him up there. Yep, it's the last one. Alright, so that is the last one we need to spawn in. We can just kind of bomb these guys now. Oh good, the glitch! On our last turn. Wonderful. On the last turn! Alright. Well, let's do it again. Yeah, let's go again! Just wanna kill the unit. This is why, like, mid-game, not late-game. Late-game's just like, alright, you made all your choices, now just watch what happens. Mid-game is like, you made some really interesting starting choices, now let's have it pay off. And next turn. As long as the Cavitans don't instantly win, we're gonna be alright.
Torgovia. Nope.
We did it.
They stood there, unmoving, eyes fixed upon stars and constellations for which they had no names. How strange this world must have seemed, their future so uncertain. Lowering their eyes to the new earth, they saw their brethren, those who had prepared this place for them, and in so doing, risked all. It was then, in that moment, they knew they were home.
Congratulations! You done it. You done good. Congratulations. We won, guys. The African Union took way longer than I've seen optimal victories by about 100 turns, actually. But we had fun. We hybridized a little bit. You know, we showed off some possible ways that might be more viable in Rising Tide, once hybridizations get certainly a buff in several regards. I'm sure you'll be able to build the gate a little bit earlier, and I'm sure it won't punish you so hard in the inability to get stronger units out earlier. But we did good! The late game there was a little boring. I'm glad we did the nice rush into Mandira. We took out their Mind Flower. That was fun. Waiting for all the Earthling settlements, not so fun. You know, not everybody declared war on me trying to stop it. I wish that was a thing they did. If the player character builds a victory wonder, I wish everybody is just like, nah, unless they're your allies, and then they just chill with you. But other than that, I had a very fun time with this Let's Play. I was able to come up with a lot of creative strategies, a lot of creative stuff. I tried to refrain from some really easily spammable stuff like academies and whatnot, and the result was that it's not like a super optimal victory, but I don't think I wasn't even really trying for that. It was more like, let's play this game, let's make interesting choices, let's see where it takes us, and I think that's a lot of fun. I had a lot of fun, guys, and I'm not sure when I'm next going to be doing a Let's Play, but certainly I'll be doing another one. I'll probably have a poll up on the Reddit page for kind of some presets I might want to go with, or maybe a sponsor choice or affinity choice for the next Let's Play. I'll probably be doing one more before Rising Tide comes out. Until next time, guys. Take care.